Hi, and welcome to the David H. Koch Hall of Fossils at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History. My name is Brian Huber, and I am a curator here at the museum. Life on planet Earth is diverse and ever-changing. Part of that constant change includes the loss of some species due to extinction. Sometimes, extinctions are caused by abrupt climatic or environmental shifts, and these can kick off a cascade of extinctions that devastates the global ecosystems called the biosphere. These are known as mass extinction events. Past mass extinctions demonstrate the fragility of ecosystems, but they also highlight the resilience of life on the planet. In this exhibit, we explore two mass extinction events, what caused them, and the effects they had on our planet. The largest mass extinction event in Earth's history occurred 252 million years ago and is known as the End-Permian Extinction. Leading up to that time, a series of volcanic eruptions lasting for a million years occurred in what is now Siberia. These eruptions ignited underground coal deposits, which burned and released carbon dioxide and methane, causing the Earth's temperature to rise. The trapped heat and carbon dioxide created acid rain, which acidified the ocean and, with the addition of toxic chemicals released by the volcanoes, led to cascading extinctions in the ocean. This brief model shows the striking change in marine ecosystems before and after these volcanic eruptions. Before, the ocean teemed with coral reefs and complex ecosystems had co-evolved for millions of years. After, the environmental catastrophes caused over 80% of ocean organisms to become extinct, and the variation in morphology among what little marine life survived on the ocean floor was much reduced. It would take millions of years for the pre-extinction diversity to recover. The most recent mass extinction event is also the most famous. It ended the age of the dinosaurs. The End-Cretaceous mass extinction event, 66 million years ago, was caused by a massive asteroid impacting the Earth. The asteroid was almost 6 miles wide and crashed into a shallow ocean that covered what is now the Yucatan Peninsula, Mexico. Over the next few days, massive tsunamis and shockwaves from the impact rippled across the planet. In some places, frictional heat and radiation energy generated from the asteroid traveling at more than 25,000 miles per hour ignited wildfires, causing smoke plumes to permeate the atmosphere. While this is not the first asteroid to crash into our planet, this was the first that has been linked to a global mass extinction. Scientists think the reason this particular impact caused such devastation include the fact that the asteroid's landing place was shallow and the ocean floor contained a highly sulfurous rock that vaporized upon impact and combined with water to fall as acid rain. The other major factor is that the ejecta cloud that blocked sunlight from reaching Earth's surface after the impact reduced the ability of plants to photosynthesize, causing a collapse of food webs on land and throughout the oceans. The End-Permian and End-Cretaceous events are not the only mass extinctions in Earth's history. Four additional mass extinctions are identified on the timeline on the north wall of our exhibit. But additional extinctions in geologic history may also qualify as mass extinction events. The criteria for what distinguishes background or minor extinctions from mass extinction events is not cut and dry. And as with all paleontological science, it depends on what evidence has been preserved and how scientists can interpret it today. For example, we know what happened with the End-Cretaceous mass extinction because the fossil record is clear. Dinosaur fossils can be found below the layer of rock and volcanic ash that marks the asteroid impact event, but they are absent from the layers above. But what would a mass extinction event look like when all life was microscopic? Such an event would have had the same devastating effects on the biosphere, but we cannot observe evidence left behind in the rocks that we find today. Regardless of the exact number of mass extinction events we currently identify, it is clear that the environmental effects of mass extinctions may last for millions of years and cause permanent changes to global ecosystems. There's evidence that we are at the onset of another mass extinction event right now. This one has nothing to do with asteroids or volcanic activity. It is caused by human actions. Increased human populations, overhunting, and global warming caused by the burning of fossil fuels strain these ecosystems to their breaking points. The species loss and environmental changes happening in what has recently been labeled as Earth's most recent mass extinction puts global ecosystems and all of us at risk. We have time now to act and prevent the destruction from reaching critical levels, but only if we act quickly. To learn more about the Deep Time exhibit, watch our other narrated virtual tours, or check out our webpage to learn more about what our scientists do here every day.